Hello everyone. So our project is based on graph convolution network and outline is divided into three modules. We will explain one by one. Okay, so let's start with basics of JCN. Real world data like these does not depend on grid. So CNN and RNN does work on these kind of data? The answer is no. But why? So, because real world data does not live on grids only. So, main idea of graph convolution network is pass messages and in between the pair of nodes and agglomerates. And the alternative interpretation is pass messages between nodes to refine node and possible edges. So, this is the structure of this. And now, the main point is how we achieve locality, aggregation, and composition of the graph. So, locality of information can be achieved by forming computational graph. It means, so let's say this is a node we are focusing. So, we will see how this rad node I is connected to its neighbors and neighbor of neighbors. So, solution of locality is generate node embedding based on local neighborhood using computational graph. In a diagram, you can see A is connected with B, C, D. Then we are looking for neighbor of neighbor. In this way, we are getting two-layer computational graph corresponding to A. So, whatever result we will obtain here is Z of A. Once the locality information preserved in computational graph, then we will start aggregating using neural network present in these blocks. And so these blocks will perform aggregation operation, which are summing of A and C to B and all these into this. And summing of B, C, D into A. We can say every node have a computational graph and computational graph is different for each and individual nodes. Each node have its own embedding in the form of feature space and feature space is one dimension feature vector for each individual nodes and dimension of that can be m into 1. So by forward propagation, we propagate the information of XA, XC, and other, all these into the output node A, having the feature vector Z of A. So Z of A will also be a n into one feature vector, but the dimension of the n is much, much smaller than the dimension of these. All right. So come to the wait update role. First step is to initialize the activation unit to be the feature vector. Here K is a position of computational graph and the activation at the 0th layer will be the feature vector itself. Second equation is a recursive equation. So at kth unit, we are actually calculating the activation unit, which are basically a function of previous activation unit. So we actually performing averaging operation here, and that is the neighborhood activation unit and dividing it by total number of neighbors. Then WK actually connecting to the activation unit and unit H of B with different weights, and these weights are trainable. The term which takes care of the bias. So BK here is bias, which are trainable, is multiplied with the node under considerations, which is V. And V can be any nodes of the graph. So bias VK is the self-loop activation for the node into the consideration. And the result will pass to the nonlinear unit. And final result will be the HV of K. Okay, so for K equals to 1 to K minus 1, we will use second equation and vector Z of A is equal to HV of K. So for K equals to 1 to K minus 1, we use second equations. And for last layer, we have embedded vector Z of A is equal to hv of k. So this is a basical this is basically the implementation of forward propagation in case of graph neural network. Now question is, how do we train the model to generate high quality embeddings? For this we need to define a loss function and on the embedding of ZA. After kth layer of neighborhood aggregation, we get output embedding for each node. We can feed these embeddings into loss function and run stochastic gradient descent to train the agglomerative parameters. Train in an unsupervised manner using only the graph structure. The alternative approach for this is directly train the model for a unsupervised task, that is node classification. This is loss function in which y of v is a node class labels and z of v is output node embeddings of this, and this theta is the classification weight. So graph convolution network is are slightly variation on the neighborhood aggregation idea, and where per neighbor normalization is different from this, and the result of which is the more parameter can share and downweights high degree neighborhood down.
So now I'm gonna talk about semi-supervised classification using GCN. Here the main theme is the same. We need to aggregate the neighborhood nodes for a single node. So we are using spectral graph theory for this task. Now in spectral graph theory we are using graph Laplacian method to do this. So graph Laplacian is basically when we subtract the adjacency matrix from the degree matrix of a graph, we get a graph Laplacian, and we are using normalized version of the graph Laplacian for this task. Now the propagation rule is basically what Nehru have said. It is the graph Laplacian matrix along with the zeroth layer hidden activation and also trainable weight matrix. So this is actually the multi-layer graph convolution with first order localized spectral filters. So here we are using two key concepts. One is Fourier domain parameterized Laplacian eigenmatrix, and second one is we need to approximate the value of this filter. So we are using Chebyshev polynomial for the approximation. Now for spectral graph convolution is basically when we multiply a signal with a filter. So in Fourier domain, we get a result, and this result can be expressed as a product value of eigenvectors. Now this eigenvalue decomposition may be expensive for a larger graph, so we need to do some kind of approximation. So here we are using Chebyshev approximation for this task, which can be approximated for a kth order node. Now Chebyshev approximation, the parameter of this approximation can be represented by theta, and the polynomial can be expressed recursively using the last equations. But this kind of localized kth order polynomial can only be aggregated for a k steps away from a central node, and this will be a simpler solution for our task, and the complexity would be the in the linear order of edges. By stacking multiple layers of the same linear filters, we can build a deeper model, but this kind of linear model can overfit for a large sparse graph which may have very wide node degree distribution. And also here we have this expression for the filter, but the eigenvalue of this Laplacian matrix can have a range from 0 to 2, which may have vanishing or exploding gradients. So they have used a normalization trick in which they have added the identity matrix within the expression. Now we can generalize this filter function for a C input channel, and this will be effectively can be expressed with a linear combination of edge and the channel. So now in supervised node classification task, we have already seen how the propagation model would look like. So this is the output of the set, and we are using activation function as softmax, and also we are using cross entropy loss for all the levels that we have. Now for the experiments, we have mainly two types of data set. One is citation network, another one is a knowledge graph. From that we extracted a bipartite graph, and the nodes and edges the nodes can be expressed as documents, and the links are expressed as undirected edges. Now the classification accuracy can be expressed, it is shown in the table, and it can be seen that they are performing better than the other competitors. Also, they have shown the results for the new de-normalization trick, which is performing very good for all the data set. Now they have also simulated some random graphs with different sizes, and they have shown that how it is performing efficiently and fast in GPU and CPU. Now finally, what we get is that the graph Laplacian regularization method that people are doing earlier, that assume that the nodes are similar, which may not be a case for a large graph. Also for a skip drum based model, we need to use multi-step pipeline for scaling up optimization. But GCN does overcome both of these limitations for using fewer parameters and fast localized filters. Now still GCN has some limitations, which is the for large graph, it may require larger memory, and for we still need to use undirected edges in place of directed ones, because this may not work for a GCN cannot be dealt with directed edges. Also, it is assumed that the local dependence are there for a graph, which may not be good for generalization. And also, this can be overcome by using some trade-off parameters. Thank you.
In the last section of the presentation, we will jump into the application perspective of the GCN. For that, we have chosen the paper Multi-Label Image Recognition with Graph Convolutional Networks, which demonstrates how GCN can be beautifully used in image analysis application. In multi-label image recognition, the task is to predict a set of object labels that are present in an image. In the left image, an example of traditional image recognition is shown, where only single instance object dog is present in the image. Unlike in the right image, where different instances of classes are present, like rainbow, clouds, and sky. Comparing to the multi-class image classification, the multi-label task is more challenging due to the combinational nature of the output space, as we need to identify a subset of total n labels out in the output space, which grows exponentially. As shown in the figure, the objects normally co-occur in the physical world. A key for multi-label image recognition is to model label dependencies. Now, the first question arises, how to utilize graph structure to model label dependencies? For this, we represent labels with nodes, and the directed edge between them depicts the impact of the presence of one label on the presence of another label in the image. The weight of the edge is represented by the conditional probability values between the two labels. The overall framework of the MLGCN consists of two main modules, image representation learning and GCN-based classification learning module. For the image representation learning, we can use any CNN-based model to learn image features. For the experiments, we have used ResNet 101 feature maps after convolutional layer and then employed a pooling layer to obtain image level features of dimension 2048. For the GCN-based classifier learning, we learn interdependent object classifiers from label representations using a two-layer GCN. The initial label embedding used is a 300-dimensional globe word embedding trained on Wikipedia dataset. So we start from the Wikipedia word embedding, and then we train a two-layer GCN, and finally we get the generated classifiers. Now we take the dot product of the image feature representation and the label classifier to identify the presence of labels in the image. This table shows the MLGCN result on the MS COCO dataset, which has a MAP of 83, which is better than the previous state-of-the-art results. On Pascal VOC dataset also, MLGCN outperforms state-of-the-art results by 2%, which has a MAP of 94. Now, some of the qualitative results are presented here to show the effectiveness of the MLGCN work. Thank you. If you have any questions, you can write back to us.